In this lesson, we're going to explore the character picker, which is a custom Python panel that you can bring up as you work in Houdini. So first, let's start by setting up a character. We're going to go to the character tab up here and use the simple biped. Press spacebar A to zoom in on this character. And what you can see is the character comes in as a single digital asset with a whole series of controls up here for working with the character, and also some controls if we get the select tool here in the viewport. So if I press the T key, you'll see that I can move the character up and down and start to pose the character. Or I can select this and press R to rotate. So this character is set up in the traditional way that a Houdini character is set up. But as you can see, all of the null objects in here sort of get in the way of the pose, make it hard to make creative decisions. So the character picker offers a nice solution to this null noise that we have. So we're going to go in and we're going to set up a new pane tab called a Python panel. Let's take this panel and we'll just knock that down. And we're going to go to the character picker example. Now, what this will allow us to do is select our character by adding a particular character, let's say the simple biped, into the panel as a character that we want to work with. And then we can start to add some layout. So we can add, for instance, a single view. We'll call this test. And from here, we can start to do things like add a button. This button can be set up for a particular target. Let's go star COG and select the control COG. This is sort of the main control on the character. Then we're going to click on here and edit label. And we're just going to say COG. And we're going to click on here and set the color to red. Now this creates a nice little thing. If we right click on it, we can move it around. And we're currently in edit mode. We can put it where we want. We can also set a background either by screen grabbing off of here from the viewport or bringing in a file. But for now, let's just show how this one marker works. So we go out of edit mode, and now basically when we click on this, we select that particular node. So we get the node that we were looking for. Now, it turns out that we don't need to build the UI for this particular character because one already exists. And if we delete this, what you'll see is we can go to this layout and we can say load a layout from the Houdini digital asset, which is the character node itself. We select that character and go accept, and you'll see that there's already a pre-built layout that exists here. Now, I'm working with a 1280 by 720 space here, so it's a little tight and I have to scroll, but if you run a proper size monitor, this would be full screen and ready for you to work with. So because of this, what we're able to do is go into here and say, let's not look at the null objects while we work. And we can simply come into here and say, okay, grab the COG. And if you use this, the handle tool, what you'll see is if I select something like the COG, I can get both the translate and the rotate for that node. I'll get both handles that are related to it. And then if I click on other handles, I'll only get the particular kind of handle that's appropriate for that handle. So now in this case, this doesn't work because there's actually IK involved. But if I click this, you'll see I can focus on where the elbow is. Similarly, I can go down to the feet. Let's say move that out. Select this one, move that out. Move that forward. If I want to bring the COG a little bit forward there, select this node, rotate. So I got a fair bit of control, all using this panel right here. It also turns out this character not just has one panel here for the body, it also has one for other things as well, things like the hands and the feet. So for instance, I can click on this and rotate that up, or I can go to the hand and rotate that in, and that in to get that as well. So as you can see, a lot of control using this custom panel. This panel is actually available as an example of the kind of panels that you can do using the new Python controls in Houdini. But for people animating characters, it is a ready-to-go and usable tool.